Well, I'm inside the Tourard Cafe and Restaurant in Morton, County Westmeath, and joining me is one half of Foster and Allen, and that's Tony Allen, one of the busiest pairs in music. Tony, you're off to the UK shortly.
Yeah, we're just back from doing a promotional tour over there, and we visited 33 regional BBC radio stations and give them all our new CD, and the all top was very good, and with the result that it's just gone into the top 40 this week in the UK.
What's the name of the new CD?
It's called Putting on the Style. It's 50 titles and 50 videos to go with all the songs. So it's a 2 CD and 1 DVD. The whole lot's in there.
You looking forward to going back on tour?
Yeah, we really enjoyed the tour. Well, England, I suppose, it's kind of... England and Ireland would be very important to us because we like touring in both places very well. We started back in England in the early 80s doing the concerts, you know, so it's an ongoing thing for years and years and years. Yeah, we start on the 27th of October and we finish on the 17th of November. We start in Edmonton out near London and we finish in Solihull, which is outside Birmingham. And in between, we go up as far as Runcorn and back down as far as Bournemouth, that direction, you know.
How can viewers follow exactly where you're playing each night?
Well, I suppose Hot Country. I'll give them a good idea of what's happening. Also, if they get on the fostonallen.ie, they'll get all the information, or the Foster and Allen Facebook. All the information is on both of them places.
What do you attribute the success of Foster and Allen down through the years? What has been your success?
Oh, that's a good question. I don't know. I suppose, in fairness, I suppose, the easy listening music has been around, as we all know, for youngs. I mean, if you go back to the British charts in the 60s, you had people like Val Dunican, The Seekers, you had all the easy listening, you know, the Bachelors, even Ken Dodd, all those people. And kind of in the 80s, they stopped... they stopped recording singles and that, and all went into television and stuff, you know. So we were lucky to get into that market, and I suppose Daniel got into that market as well, you know. And we've been very, very lucky because we've had an album every year since. We've had an album in the British charts every year from 1983, and now this is 2018 sorted.
And also, of course, not alone do you do Ireland and the UK, but you do further afield like the USA, Australia, New Zealand on a regular basis.
Yeah, this year alone we were in New Zealand for a month. We did, I think, 19 shows. When we finish the English tour now, we'll start an Irish tour the night after Boxing Night. We're in Shum, and then we're in Armagh the following night. And then we'll go right through the month of January around Ireland. And in March then we're off to Scotland. We have, I think, about 18 shows in Scotland. And then in May we got back to Australia for our 20th trip.
Do you ever get tired of travelling?
Get tired of flying around the world, but when you get there, the travelling to the gigs is not a big problem. It's just getting there and getting back, you know.
And Tony, would you have a message for your fans in the UK before you go over on this next tour?
Yeah, well, we hope that we'll see as many of them as we possibly can, and as they all know, you know, we'll be there after the show to meet them all and say hello to them and any of them that want to hang around, you know. But, you know, come out and say hello to us anyway and see what they think of the show.
Tony Allen, can you remember the first time you heard yourself on radio? The first time you recorded and then you heard yourself on radio?
First time we ever did a recording was with Foster and Allen. That was back in the mid-70s. And I suppose at that time, pirate radio was the one. That would have been the first place I heard myself, you know. And then, of course, it was amazing to hear yourself on RTE radio after a few years. And I suppose, in fairness, back in the 70s, we had a lot of good shows, you know. You had Tramagus Atrum and Donica's Travels, and The Late Late Show was amazing then. Like, you know, most of those shows are gone now. But thanks be to God, they're all been replaced by Sky, which is great because it's worldwide.
Tony Allen of Foster and Allen, can you remember any embarrassing moments while on stage?
Well, I do. Yeah, I remember once I forgot the words of Maggie, which was a bit embarrassing, all right. And not the last tour of New Zealand, but the tour before, we do a medley of songs, and the last song on the medley is Blue Eyes Crying in the Rain. And could I remember a word of it? Not a chance.
Tony Allen, thank you very much for joining us.
You're very welcome, and thank you, Hugh.